bright duty. Every student matters.
Hi children, welcome to the session. Today we are going to learn about thunderstorms and cyclone. So let's just start with the word thunderstorm. So children, as you can observe from the picture, thunderstorm means a storm which occurs with a huge sound which we call as thunder. You know that thunder is always accompanied with lightning. So today we are going to discuss about this thunderstorm. So children, when air moves gently, that is with a very slow speed, we call it as breeze, okay? But when it moves with violently, that is when it is moving with a very high speed, we call it as a storm. And when the pressure of air drops, it indicates the possibility of storm. And guys, usually this thunderstorm is created in regions which are usually hot and humid, okay? And we are going to discuss how are these thunderstorms formed. So guys, the swift movement of falling water along with rising warm air producing sound, lightning, heavy rain and sometimes hailstorms and strong wind, it is known as thunderstorm, okay? So it develops in a hot and humid tropical areas like India and it is accompanied with heavy rain or hail, okay? And thunderstorms are produced by the dark clouds which are formed at fairly low altitude in the atmosphere. So guys, what happens is the air above the air which gets heated up, it makes it rise upwards. So as we know, the hot air starts rising upwards, whereas the humidity which is present in the atmosphere, it provides water vapor to this air in order to form clouds, okay? Whereas the humidity is providing what? Water vapor for the formation of clouds. And therefore, there is said to occur a thunderstorm because it requires moisture, rapidly rising warm air and sea breeze, okay? So these are all the conditions which are necessary in order for a thunderstorm to form. I hope it must be clear to all of you. So guys, what should be done while you come across a thunderstorm? You should never take a shelter under an isolated tree or building. If you are in a forest, take a shelter under a small tree. Do not lie on the ground. Do not take shelter under an umbrella having a metallic end. Why? Because it can catch lightning. Okay. Then you should never sit near a window, open garages. Mainly you should not go into open areas. Then one can take shelter in a car or a bus and you should not go in water. Okay. These are the precautions that you must take during a thunderstorm. Then guys, what is a cyclone? So guys, the rotating thunderstorm can be called as a cyclone. Let's discuss how is it formed. A cyclone is a weather condition consisting of a system of high speed winds which are revolving around a center of very low pressure. So guys, in the center of this cyclone, there is a very calm and area of low pressure. And around this, there is this huge storm which is rotating. So this is known as a cyclone. You can also observe this in this picture. So cyclones develop over tropical areas. It is a violent storm with a very high speed of 150 to 250 kilometers per hour. And anything which comes across it will be destroyed because of it. Okay, because of its high speed. And it is accompanied by very strong winds and heavy rains. Okay. So let's see what is the structure of this cyclone. So guys, at the center, the calm zone, low pressure area is known as the eye of the cyclone. This is known as the eye of the cyclone. So the center of cyclone is a calm area. It is called as the eye of the storm. And the diameter of this eye may vary from 10 to 30 kilometers. It is a region free of clouds, which means there is no cloud in the center of this cyclone and it has light winds. And around this calm and clear eye, there is a cloud region about 150 kilometers in size. And in this region, there are high speed winds, which we have already discussed. It can vary from 150 to 250 kilometers per hour. And thick clouds with heavy rain away from this region, the wind speed gradually decreases. Okay. And let's just see we have a note here. Cyclones are developed over the Indian Ocean, Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea. The whole coastline of India is vulnerable to cyclones, and meteorologists study weather and give names to different cyclones. Okay, they are named as Katrina, Rita, Hugo, okay, Fallon. These are all the names of different cyclones. You might have often heard about these cyclones in the news also. Okay, then guys, how are thunderstorms converted into a cyclone? Okay, let's just study. So before the formation of cloud, water takes up heat from the atmosphere and change into vapor. And when water vapor changes back into the liquid in the form of raindrops, this heat is released. This heat is released into the atmosphere. The heat released to the atmosphere warms the air around. The air tends to rise up. Now this air will rise up and causes a drop in the pressure. The pressure will be reduced, and more the air rushes towards the center of the storm, this cycle is repeated. Okay, and the chain of events ends in the formation of a low pressure zone in the center of the cyclone, which is called as the eye of the cyclone. And the formation of very low pressure system with very high speed winds revolving around it. And it is this condition that we call as cyclone. And some of the factors which leads to the development of cyclone are high speed winds, wind direction, temperature and humidity. Okay guys, so this is all about cyclone, and I really hope thunderstorm and cyclone are clear to you. Thank you so much for your attention.